Hey everyone, happy Monday. My name's Jess. This is Movement Monday. Thanks for joining me today. Today we're gonna do a workout using a pool noodle. If you don't have a pool noodle, you can use a golf club or canoe paddle, lacrosse stick, a broomstick even. So we're just gonna do a nice movement. It's a really hot July day. Make sure you have your water. I have a fan going next to me. You may also want a mat. So cue up some music and we'll get started with our workout today. Okay, we'll do a warm up to begin. Just starting with some nice easy squats, sitting back, driving through those heels, keeping our chest lifted, squeezing your glutes as you stand up. Now we'll do some hip rotations. So just opening up that hip, nice movements, nice big movements with those legs. And bring them the other way. It's a good day to go swimming. Go ahead and do some nice arm circles. Start nice and slow, increasing in size. Bigger, really loosening up those shoulders. Reverse direction, start really small and get bigger and bigger. Nice. Do a lateral lunge and the other side. Really sitting back on that bent knee. Feeling the nice inner thigh stretch. Go ahead and lunge forward. Put both of your hands inside your foot. Follow your hand and do a nice stretch there. And other leg forward. Hands inside and a nice stretch here. Do one more on each side. And let's do a couple of those. Inchworms. So squatting down, walking our hands out into a high plank position, walking them back, nice big arms, and repeat. You can add a push-up. Do that one more time. March it out a little bit. Get those legs moving. So grab your noodle, your paddle, your broomstick, whatever it is that you're going to be using. If you don't have anything, no problem. You can still have a great workout. Just adds a little variety and helps you focus a little bit on certain muscle groups. So the first thing we're going to be doing is an overhead squat. So just going into that nice squat that we just warmed up with. And then reaching that noodle overhead, trying to get those elbows in line with your ears. So we'll do 10 of those. Five. Really driving through those heels as we stand. 8, 9, and 10. Good. All right. now we're gonna do a single leg RDL. So we've done these in the past. Lots of tightness here in your abdominal to keep your balance. We're really working our glute and hamstring as we drive our leg back. So hinge at your hips, drive your leg back. Don't be afraid to lose your balance, and bringing your noodle forward. We'll do 10 on one side, and then 10 on the other. That abdominal nice and tight. It helps me to keep my balance. Leg is going straight back, really activating those glutes and your hamstring. Nice. Okay. Our next one from here will be a plank walk. So I'm going to have you set your noodle down on the floor. A little adjustment. Go into a high plank position. So hands underneath your shoulders. Nice, tight abdominal region, squeezing your butt. And we're going to walk with your hands and feet the distance of your noodle and walk it back. Keeping that nice, tight abdominal, no movement in the hips. All right, so we'll do that. And half kneeling rotation. So for this, go ahead and set your noodle behind you on your shoulders. Your arm should be making a nice W shape. Right leg forward, 90 degrees, and twist to the right, hold for 1 or 2 seconds, and back to center. Keeping those shoulders back, squeezing those shoulder blades together. Abdominals nice and tight as well. That's 5, 6, 7. So 10 on one side and then 10 on the other. Keeping those shoulders back, squeezing those shoulder blades, abdominals nice and tight. 5. All right. So the next time, or the next exercise we're going to do is we're using the noodle just to kind of help you focus on the movement. So we're going to get down on our bellies into a prone position. This is called a prone cobra. So for this, you're going to just rest your noodle in the middle of your back, because what you're going to be doing is really squeezing those shoulder blades together. So start with your palms flat down. Face down. You're going to raise your shoulders up off the floor. As you do it, you're going to externally rotate so that your thumbs are pointed up and you're squeezing those shoulder blades together. So squeeze that noodle nice and tight. We'll do that 10 times. So lower, hands go down onto the floor. raising those shoulders, squeezing those shoulder blades together. And we'll do that for 10. 5, 6, and 10. Nice. All right. Set your noodle up on the floor. And we're gonna do a little bit of metabolic work. So for this, make sure your shoelaces are tied. For this, you're gonna go up, down, up, down, jumping over your noodle. Nice, fast feet. And back. So do that one or two times through, and then we'll go and do a side. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's a little bit of metabolic training. You can do one or two times up and down, just depending on how long you want to continue with that metabolic portion. So let's go ahead and take it from the top. We'll start with those overhead squats. We're going to be working in set repetitions of 10. So 10 of these, ready, and begin. 1. Definitely feel tightness in my shoulders. How about you? So things like prone cobra are great for strengthening those rhomboids and trapezius muscles that need to be strengthened in order to really get a nice movement there. So good thing we're incorporating that one today. All right, single leg RDLs. Other side, kicking that leg straight back. Go into those plank walks. Set your noodle down. Go into that high plank position. And walk your hands in the distance. Let's do it again. W shape and hold for 2. Squeeze blades and those shoulder blades together. Other side. Alright, nice job. Okay, so we'll go into that prone cobra. Remember, we're just using the noodle in the middle of our backs to remind us to really squeeze those shoulder blades together. Starting with our hands down, externally rotating so that our thumbs are up as we lift our shoulders off the floor, really squeezing those shoulder blades together for 10. Metabolic work as well as coordination work. So up, down, and back. You can go through that again. Nice. And let's do it laterally. 1, 2, 3. Just start again from the top with those overhead squats. Feet hip width apart, driving through those heels, trying to get those hands up. Definitely tighten my shoulders. We are hosting using your foam roller workshop coming up pretty soon. I believe it's August 12th. So we'll be learning how to use a foam roller to help you loosen up some of your tight muscles. For me, it'll definitely be in my shoulders and upper back and my pecs. So have a look at our website to sign up for that. It's a virtual class in conjunction with Be Fit. So it'll be a great way to learn how to use a foam roller for those tight muscles, increase your flexibility. 6. Switch legs. Okay, now we get to go back into our plank walks. Let's do it again. On the back of your shoulders, squeezing those shoulder blades together, and rotating. Go back into that prone cobra position. This is such a great back and shoulder exercise. I love this one. Okay, so palms at your side, or palms straight down, raising your shoulders, squeezing those shoulder blades together, and externally rotating. Thumbs up. Squeezing that noodle between your shoulder blades. The top overhead squat. Go ahead and finish up. 7, 8. All right, good job. Keep going if you want. You kind of know the routine, but I will start to do a cool down right now. So first of all, grab your quad, or grab your ankle, stretching out your quad. Make sure you get a lot of water today. It's a very hot and humid. But thanks for joining me. It is hot. Sometimes you don't want to really move around much unless you're swimming when it's hot. Switch legs. But every day you should be moving, even if it means getting up early, getting a fan blowing on you. But I do love these hot summer days, I'm not gonna lie. All right, cross one leg over the other, do a nice figure four stretch, sit back, really feel that in your outer thigh. Other side. Sit back. You really feel it out here in your outer hip, outer thigh area. All right, time to do hamstring. So toe up. Hinging at your hips, leaning forward, trying to touch your toe or ankle or knee, really feeling that stretch in your hamstring and in your glutes. And switch legs, toe up, hinging at the hips. Nice stretch here in your hamstring. All right, keep that body hinging at the hips and pretend you're holding a baby, kind of rocking it back and forth. Chest, holding your hands behind, squeeze those shoulder blades together, opening up your chest. A couple of nice shoulder rotations. Rotating backward and forward. Pull your shoulders down away from your ears. Look over your right shoulder. Feel a nice stretch in your neck. Center and over to your left side, keeping those shoulders pressed down and away from your ears. Arm across your chest. Stretching out those triceps. And over your head. Other side. Thank you. one last one. Grab onto a wall or bookshelf or something and sit back, stretching out your back and shoulders. You can move a little bit side to side. So thanks for joining me today. Remember to keep moving. It doesn't have to be complicated. Just a bunch of stretches is great, are great. Swimming, walking, even on these really hot days, just make sure you stay hydrated. But keep moving and make it fun. I mean, find things in your house like pool noodles or broomsticks and create a workout around that. There's a lot of great offerings we have on our Facebook page and YouTube channel, so make sure you check all that out. So good health to you, and I hope to see you next week for Movement Monday. All right, have a good day.